your career and when did you decide to apply?
I'm an interior designer. I have been practicing design for 20 years and I decided to go into design when I was in college.
Why did you decide you wanted to be an interior designer?
I knew that I was interested in interior design as I was growing up. My parents used to take us on tours of historical houses and of museums, and I always thought that seeing how other people lived was so interesting. I also liked to do a lot of art projects, and I liked to be creative. It wasn't until I was in college, though, that I realized that interior design was an actual job I could do. And when I realized I could put my interest in homes and my interest in art together as one career, interior design became my chosen career.
What education do you need for this job?
I went to a four-year program at a university, and I have my Bachelor of Science in Interior Design. There are some programs where you can get a two-year degree from a community college, or you can even move on to get your master's or doctorate in interior design.
What does being an interior designer entail?
I think the most important thing being a designer entails is having imagination, but you also need a strong skill set and technical capabilities, such as you do need to know some math. You need to be aware of health and safety regulations, so it's not just all colors and pillows. You have to have knowledge of how to design a space so that it is safe as well as functional and as well as a fun, creative place to be in.
What is fun about your job?
I think my job is really fun. Not only do I get to meet lots of different people and go to lots of different places, I have lots of different types of projects. So every project is something new. I get to travel a lot, I get to be really creative, and I get to get people excited about something new that's going to be happening in their lives.
What kind of projects have you had in the past?
I've worked on all different types of projects in the past. I have done a lot of people's homes. I've also worked with law firms. I've worked with restaurants. I've done a hotel or two, I think. Probably two or three hotels. I've also worked in church facilities, so designing the auditoriums and spaces within the church, as well as the kids areas and classrooms. And I've also worked at schools, working at a private Catholic school in Harrisonburg, and I've also done university work for JMU as well as a few others.
How old do you have to be to dive right in and start?
I would say that as soon as you graduate from college or community college, you can get started as a career as a designer. But in the meantime, there are so many things you can do as, I would say, as a young teenager, as a teenager, or even as a college kid. You can design your own bedroom. There's lots of blogs to look at and get inspiration from. And you could even get a part-time job after school working for a furniture store.
How can a kid learn more about your job?
Well, if you've ever seen a TV show on HGTV, you've already seen a tiny little piece of what interior design can be. I would also suggest checking out websites and blogs. There are websites like Apartment Therapy that you can look up. BuzzFeed also has a lot of top 10 lists that might be able to give you an indication of some things that you can do in design. And lastly, I would say ask adults that you see that if you like this way their space looks, or if you go into a store and you like what they're selling, I would ask the people who work there and see what they can teach you about how they chose the products or the space that they're in.
Have you ever come across a challenge that was so difficult for you? If so, how did you overcome it?
I'll say every project comes with a challenge, and the challenge is always, how can I get as much of what I want into the project with my budget? So money is always an issue. But the real challenge comes in finding ways to be creative and come up with a solution that does fit within the client's budget. And oftentimes it's those constraints and things that we want to do in the beginning that we can't do because of money that lead us to our most innovative ideas and end up coming out better, being better solutions at the end of the project than what our original idea was.
Lastly, what does an average day on the job look like for you?
That's what's so cool about my job. An average day is not always average. I get to do all types of things. So one day I may be spending most of the day at the computer and drawing and designing spaces. But another day I could be out in the field taking measurements for a project that we will be doing work on. Or even my favorite part of the job is at the end of the project when we get to see the space being completed and we go in and make sure that everything looks the way that we meant it to look. And then that's when we get to hang pictures and do artwork and all the fun things that finally make the space feel like it's complete and ready for people to start enjoying.